using a private jet. Hillary Clinton flew out of here just a few hours ago, but earlier today, about 200 or more than 200 people turned out in northeast Albuquerque to hear the senator and to see her. But not everything was up to expectations, and not all the news out of her camp, that is, was positive.
Mark, are you commenting about Mark Penn?
Questions about ousted chief strategist Mark Penn, not what Hillary Clinton could hear or wanted to hear as she left Albuquerque this evening. Earlier, she met with more than 200 supporters at a fundraiser at former Ambassador Ed Romero's house.
I really sense that there's, and I felt it here, that the momentum is changing.
And while Romero says this event exceeded all expectations, he also acknowledged her opponent is raising more.
So I don't think she needs to match Obama dollar for dollar. I think she just has to raise enough, you know, to make a viable and an interesting campaign, and she is.
I got to meet her, got to chat with her, and my son and I got a picture with her. So
Bernalillo County DA Kerry Brandenburg, Lieutenant Governor Diane Denish, and Mayor Martin Chavez, some of the other big names. We even saw outed former CIA agent Valerie Plame dash to her car where her husband Joe Wilson waited. Martha Burke, who came to prominence trying to get women into Augusta National Golf Course, home of the Masters, is Clinton's campaign co-chair in New Mexico.
What I think is new is if you want to get a job done, send a woman. She didn't say it, but somebody in the audience said it, and it really resonated.
One big New Mexico politician missing, Governor Bill Richardson, who endorsed Barack Obama about 2 weeks ago.
The governor did what he thought he had to do, what he wanted to do, and I'm not going to question his motives or his reasoning or what have you. He's an astute man. He does his own thing, and he did what he had to do.
Now, tonight's turnout exceeded expectations. As for Ed Romero, he was the governor's finance guy before the governor actually dropped out of the race. To get in the door today, it cost anywhere from $1,000 to $2,300. Now, one thing I did hear Senator Clinton mention, I was out on the street, she was talking in the backyard, but she was using a microphone. She said she is back in the game with enough resources, and it ain't over till it's over. Now, as for Mark Penn's departure, it had to do with the free trade agreement he was working on for Colombia. In southeast Albuquerque, Mike Garofalo, KOAT Action 7 News.